In this lesson, we're going to learn how to reduce the number of polygons on this model to better prepare it for level of detail use in a game. Now, if we go up to this display menu, we can show smooth wired shaded and get a sense of the topology on the surface. If we double-click on the node to go down to the geometry level, we can middle-click on the node here and actually get a polygon count. Looks like it's about 20,000 points and 20,000 polygons, and our goal will be to reduce this down. If we go back into this view and press N to select all the geometry, we can press Tab and start to spell out polyreduce. As soon as we get to the R, we can press Enter. Now, we don't want any crease edges for now, so just press Enter to accept that and deselect here. Now, what we have is the original model because we haven't done any reducing yet. If you come down to the node here, you'll see that we have to pull on this slider to actually go through and start to reduce that down. And you see if we get down to, let's say, around 17%, we get a pretty good look at what's possible there. Now, there are a number of options that feed into this, include optimization, stiffening, equalizing the edges if we want to control how it looks there. And also, we can use some of the original points to define how that model is working, although we don't. It seems a little smoother if we don't do that. So there we are. We've been able to reduce it using a percentage. We can also do it using just pure numbers. So in this case, we could say we want 1,000 points, or we could specifically say, let's say, 2,000 points. Let's try about 2,500. And there we go. We've been able to reduce the model down. If we middle click on there, you'll see there's our 2,500 polygons to match what we've got going here. So I hope this has shown you how you can reduce the number of polygons on a model, and of course control that procedurally using this tool.